Hi, welcome to my 7th video in the playlist of UPSC Max Optional. So, in the previous videos, we are solving the problems based on matrix of linear transformation. Now, you recall one thing, in the last video, we saw the definition of null space. So, the null space, let V and W be vector space over the field F. Let T be a linear transformation from V into W. Then the null space of T is the set of vectors alpha in V such that T alpha is equal to 0, such that is the set of vectors which are mapped to 0 is called the null space of T. Now suppose in question if they ask us to find the null space, we want to find the solution of Ax equal to 0 where A is a matrix which we obtained in the transformation, that is we will obtain a matrix, so take that matrix as A. For example, in the previous sum we found the matrix of T to be 1 1 1 0 0 1 0 0 minus 1 0 1 1 0, so take this matrix as A. Now Ax equal to 0. Now you want to solve the system Ax equal to 0 and you should find the value of x. So this x will serve as a null space for the transformation. Now in the previous sum they also asked us to find the null space of T. Here look at here. T is a function from M2 of R to P2 of X. That is here M2 of R is the set of all two cross two matrices, and P2 is the polynomial of degree less than or equal to 2. Now we already found the matrix of T with respect to the basis, standard basis, in the last video. Now it is a matrix of T is 1 1 1 0 1 0 0 minus 1 0 1 1 0. Now they also asked us to find the null space of T. In order to find the null space, we need to find the solution of the system Ax equal to 0. A into x is equal to 0, where A is the matrix which we obtain as T. Now, in the previous videos, we already know how to solve the system Ax equal to 0. Now, in order to find whether the vectors are linearly independent or linearly dependent, I demonstrated how to solve the system Ax equal to 0. Now let me recall again. Here it is, homogeneous system of linear equation, that is which is same as Ax is equal to 0. Here A is the matrix which you obtain in the transformation and x is the number of unknown variables. If it is R3, it will be x1, x2, x3. If it is R4, it will be x1, x2, x3 and x4. And O, 0 is the 0 column vector. Now look at very carefully. If rank of A is same as rank of AO, you kindly watch the previous videos before watching this video. This I taught in part 3, but now we are in part 7. Now, if the rank of A is same as rank of AO, that is both are equal to N, where N is the number of unknown variable. If both the rank are equal to the number of unknown variable, it means the solution is, it has only a trivial solution, which means it is linearly independent. So look at very carefully. Now we should find the matrix of T and we should reduce the matrix to an upper triangular matrix. Now if the reduced matrix of T is linearly independent, that is the rank of A is same as rank of AO is equal to N, it means the matrix of T with respect to the basis is linearly independent. So if the matrix of T with respect to some basis is linearly independent, listen carefully, the matrix which we obtain, look at, I take this example, the matrix which we obtain, we should reduce this matrix to upper triangular matrix, and then we should find the rank of A and rank of AO. If both are equal to N, Here the number of unknown variable is 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. If both are equal to 4, it means it is linearly independent. Now listen carefully. If it is linearly independent, it has only trivial solution. So it means 0 is the only vector which mapped to 0. So this is the conclusion we get. If the matrix of T with respect to the basis is linearly independent, it means 0 is the only vector which mapped to 0. So the null space of T will always contain only one vector which is 0 vector. Clear? If the matrix of T with respect to the standard basis is linearly independent, then the null space of T always contain only one vector which is 0 vector. Now, if it is not linearly independent, it means a non-trivial solution exists. So, if it is not linearly independent, if the rank both are equal to less than n, it means it is linearly dependent, and it means there exists a non-trivial solution which maps to 0. So, in order to find the null space of T, we should find the matrix of T and we should check whether it is linearly independent or linearly dependent. If it is linearly independent, the null space will always contain only the 0 vector. If it is linearly dependent, we should solve the system. Clear? Now, I am going to tell how to solve the system if the vectors are linearly dependent. Clear? If it is linearly independent, the only solution is all are equal to 0. If it is linearly dependent, means non-trivial solution exists. So, how to find the non-trivial solution? That I am going to explain in this video. Now, consider this example. Here, in this example, they asked us to find the null space of T. Find the matrix of T and also find the null space of T. Now, in order to find the null space of T, first we should find the matrix of T with respect to the given basis. After finding the matrix of T, we should reduce this matrix to upper triangular matrix. Now, here is the question. Find the matrix of T and then also find the null space of T. Now, we are going to find the null space of this transformation. That is, I am saying, what is meant by null space is, we are going to find the vectors which are mapped to 0. Now, this is part 7. Now, the matrix of T with respect to the basis, I am taking this matrix as A. So, the A here is 1, 1, 1, 0. 1, 1, 1, 0 and then 1, 0, 0, minus 1 and then the last row 0, 1, 1, 0. You take this matrix as A. Now, you reduce this matrix to upper triangular matrix. Now, in order to reduce to upper triangular matrix, so we have already done lots of problems in reducing this matrix to an upper triangular matrix. Now, this element is already 0. You don't need to worry about this. Now, you want to make this element as 0. So, for that, I am making R2 is equal to R2 minus R1. So, the A will be equivalent to, this will be reduced to 1, 1, 1, 0 and 1 minus 1 is 0. 0 minus 1 is minus 1, 0 minus 1 is minus 1, minus 1 minus 0 is minus 1, and the third row is as it is. Now, you should make this element 0. For that, I am making the transformation R3 is equal to R3 plus R2. So, this will be reduced to 1, 1, 1, 0, 0 minus 1, minus 1, minus 1, 0, 0, 0, minus 1. Now, we have reduced this matrix. Now look at here, the rank of A is the total number of non-zero rows. So, rank of A. Now, you make this matrix to A is equal to 0. Here, A is the reduced matrix 1 1 1 0 0 minus 1 minus 1 minus 1 here it is also now and then 0 0 0 minus 1 and x is the number of unknown variable. So here I have 4 columns, it means 4 unknown variable x1 x2 x3 and x4, or you can also write a b c d because here it is mentioned as a b c d, so you can also choose a b c d. This is equal to 0 0 0 0. Now what is the matrix of AO? AO, A is reduced matrix 1 1 1 0 0 minus 1 minus 1 minus 1 0 0 0 minus 1 and then you should make some dotted line and then you put the 0 column. Now what is the rank of A? Rank of A is the total number of non-zero rows, it is 3, and rank of A comma O, it is also 3. So both are equal to 3. But what is n here? Here n here is 4. N denotes the number of unknown variable. Here n is equal to so 4. So both are equal to 3 and less than n. And less than n. So again you need to understand the theory very well. Look at here. If both are equal and less than n, it has a non-trivial solution. So it has a non-trivial solution. It means the 0 vector is not the only one which is mapped to 0, but there are also some vectors which are mapped to 0. That it means here it is M2 of R, which is the domain, and P2 of R is the codomain. Now, here we are finding that, here we are finding the number of vectors, the set of vectors which are mapped to 0. So we always know 0 is the one, 0 always mapped to 0. So zero vector of M2 of R will always be mapped to zero vector of P2 of R. Now if it is linearly independent, it means 0 is the only vector which is mapped to 0. If it is linearly dependent, it means there are also some vectors which mapped to 0. So we are going to find the set of vectors which are mapped to 0. Now it means it has a non-trivial solution. Now we are going to find the solution for this system. In order to find the solution, you take this matrix Ax equal to 0. It's very easy, but you should understand it very well. Now you take this matrix Ax equal to 0 and then you multiply here. Multiply this row by this column. So this will become x1 plus x2 plus x3 equal to 0. X1 plus x2 plus x3 0 times x4, so x4 will be vanished, is equal to the first vector. Now here x1 is 0, so minus x2 minus x3 minus x4 is equal to 0. Here 0 x1 0 x2 0 x3 and minus x4 is equal to 0. Now we have to solve this system and we need to find x1, x2, x3 and x4. Now here you mark this equation as 1, you mark this equation as 2 and mark this equation as 3. Now from 3 it is clear that x4 is equal to 0. So we have found what is meant by what is the value of x4. Now this is also a very important concept. You look at here, what is the rank here? It is 3. But what is the number of unknown variable? It is 4. So 4 minus 3 is 1. So number of free variable is the number of unknowns minus the rank. So we'll have one variable to be free. Clear? So number of free variable is equal to total number of unknowns minus rank. So in this transformation we will have 4 minus 3 is 1. So the number of free variable is 1. So one variable is free. So you can assume any variable to be some constant. So I'm assuming x3 is equal to t. Clear? Here the number of free variable is 1. You can assume any one of the variable x1, x2, x3 as your own. You can assume any value for x1, x2, x3. But simply you assume x3 is equal to t. Clear? Now we should find x1 and x2. Now from 2 we have minus x2, minus x3 is t, x4 is 0. So this will become minus x2 is equal to t. This will become x2 is equal to t. So we have found x4, x3 and x2. Now substitute the value of x2 and x3 in equation 1. You will find x1. So what is x1 here? X1 from 1 we have x1 is, we want to find x2 is t and x3 is also t. Sorry, this x2 is minus t here. X2 is minus t because you have to bring this minus sign to here. So x2 is minus t here. So this will become x2 is minus t is equal to 0. This becomes, this two will be cancelled. This becomes x1 is equal to 0. So we have found x1, x2, x3 and x4. So the null space is, so write the answer directly. So the null space null space of T is equal to the set of vectors x1, x2, x3 and x4. So what is the value of x1 here? X1 is 0, comma x2. X2 is minus t, x3 is t, x4 is 0 again. So this is the set of vectors which map to 0. Now here the sum is over up to now, but I illustrate what it means, illustration. Now you need to solve up to this in exam, but I'm going to tell what this really means. Now I'll give illustration. Now here x1, x2, x3, x4 is the value of a, b, c, d. So I already mentioned that you can also write a, b, c, d. Now what is the transformation we are given? You don't need to write this in exam, but I'm just giving a clarity what it really means. So the null space is 0 minus t, t 0. It means, what is the transformation here? T is a function from m to r to p to of r. That is, set of all 2 cross 2 matrices to polynomials of degree less than or equal to 2. So the transformation is t of a, b, c, d is equal to, look at here, a plus b plus c, a plus b plus c and a minus d times x plus b plus c times x square. So what it means is, now there are infinite number of vectors which are mapped to 0. If I substitute t is equal to 1, then the null space will be 0 minus 1, 1, 0. If I substitute t is equal to 2, then the null space will be t 0 minus 2, 2, 0. Now, for example, if t is equal to 1, then the null space n of t will be 0 minus 1, 1, 0. Now, you should take this as a, b, c, d. Now, look at substitute in transformation, that is t of a, b, c and d. So this will become a plus b plus c. So this will become 0 minus 1 plus 1 plus a minus d, 0 minus 0 x plus b minus c. B plus c is minus 1 plus 1 times x square. So it means this will be 0, this will be 0 again, it means 0. So it means this vector is mapped to 0 vector of P2 of R. Now if I substitute T is equal to 2 here, again this vector 0 minus 2, 2, 0, this will also become 0. So it means the set of vectors which are in the pattern 0 minus T, T 0 are mapped to 0 vector in P2 of R. So this is what the null space literally means. So for this sum, the null space of t is the set of all vectors which are in this pattern. So t minus t, t is 0. So when the vectors, when the matrix is in this pattern, you will always obtain the answer as 0 if you substitute here. So it means the set of all matrices of this form are mapped to 0 vector in P2 of R. So it is, here it is M2 of R, here it is P2 of R. So the set of all matrices 0 minus T, T 0. So there are infinite number of matrices of this form because T can take any number. So there will be an infinite number of matrices which are mapped to 0 vector. So it will be mapped to 0. So there are lot of matrices which are in the form are mapped to 0 vector. So this is how to find the null space of the transformation. So in order to find the null space of the system, I'll quickly recap what we have to do. We have to find the matrix of T and take that matrix as A, and you need to solve the system Ax is equal to 0. Now you reduce the matrix A to upper triangular matrix, and then you find the rank of A and rank of AO. If both are equal to n, if both are equal to the number of unknown variable, it means linearly independent, and you can straight away directly write that null space can only contain the 0 vector. It means 0 vector is the only one which map to 0. So suppose if it is not, if it is the both the rank are equal less than the number of unknown variable, you have to solve the system Ax equal to 0. Now you should write the reduced matrix A, and then X is the number of unknowns. Here it is M2 of R. So I have 4 number of unknowns. So written as X1, X2, X3 and X4. And then you need to multiply the matrices like this. And then you find here, if both are equal to 3, so the number of free variable is 1. So the number of free variable is 1. So you can assume any value in your own. So I'm assuming X3 is equal to T. And then with the help of X4 and X3, I'm finding X2 and X1. So I'm finding 4 vectors. It means when I have an X1, X2, X3, X4 as 0 minus T, T 0, the set of vectors which are in this pattern will be mapped to 0 vector in the codomain, which is P2 of R. So this is how to find the null space for the transformation. So the next video will continue the problem. So the next video we have to solve the third problem. The third problem is similar. First we have to find the matrix of T, and then we have to find the null space of T. So we'll see in the next video. Goodbye. Thank you.